Hello there guys, Dave Nini right here, and today I'm doing another Christmassy movie review. However, this is a very recent film that was released on December 4th. And if I'm not mistaken, this video should be uploaded in December still, you know, around Christmas time. Hopefully it won't be uploaded late. Anyways, let's get enough track. Now, this is a different type of Christmas movie. This is a Christmas horror comedy. Now, in the trailer, which I saw when I went to go see The Visit back in mid-September, and, you know, I was thinking, like, oh, okay, it's going to be a Christmassy, like, family dramedy or whatever, something along those types. And then a bunch of scary stuff happened. I was like, oh, dang, it's going for a horror movie vibe. And so, actually, it looked really clever, and I've been excited for Krampus for months. I really wanted to see this movie. I was very excited. I was thinking it was going to be great, but I was trying not to overhype myself too much. I didn't want to be unfair and have unfair expectations. So I went into the movie with an open mind, like, okay, you know, as usual, just going to absorb what I see. And the movie was not as good as what I would have hoped, but is definitely a solid movie, and I'll talk about that more after I get over the plot. Now, the plot is about someone of a dysfunctional, a disgruntled family, basically, and the only family member that's been trying to keep on to hold on to hope and, you know, try to be happy and keep the Christmas spirit and believe in Santa Claus is the young son. But something happens when the in-laws come in for Christmas for a few days, and, well, he decides to rip up his letter, throw it into the sky. Well, it ends up getting sucked into the sky, and apparently gets sent straight to Krampus, who is the anti-Santa. He is just, you know, the devil version of Santa Claus. You know, he's evil. And, you know, Krampus comes down, and he's like, oh, okay, you don't like Christmas? Well, bam, monsters get put in your house. This is the worst plot description I've ever said. The point is, scary stuff happens, they have to survive, and you get a clever horror film. Now, if the trailer made it look like it was going to be a straight-up horror movie, which confused me a little bit, considering the cast is made up of all comedic actors, and yet the trailer just looked like, yeah, this is meant to scare you. No, but the movie does have comedy. It is a horror comedy. Like, I was thinking that it kind of should be. There are funny moments. There are some jokes here and there that don't kind of work, or don't work very well, but, you know, there's some funny moments, you know. The in-laws, they're pretty much the same as, like, you know, Eddie and all the other in-laws that come into, you know, the Griswold family house in Christmas Vacation. Only not nearly as funny as that, but, you know, there's some pretty funny moments, and there's some lines that made me laugh out loud at times, and there's good dialogue, you know, it's fun. The characters, okay, I was about to say the characters, no, the characters not all likable. The characters are all portrayed well in the way they're supposed to be by the actors. That the acting is all done very well, especially from Adam Scott, who plays the father, and from Toni Collette, who plays the mother. Like, the only likable characters are Adam Scott, Toni Collette, and the little boy. And then all the in-laws are just douchebags. Oh, well, that's right, the grandma character. She's nice. But yeah, all the in-laws, they're just douchebags. But they are funny. You know, there's some funny moments, like I said. But actually, what I appreciated, and, like, other people haven't said this in other reviews, which kind of surprised me, but I don't know, I guess that's just what they think. But honestly, by the end, I honestly thought pretty much everyone became likable, because, like, most of the unlikable characters there in the gang, like, pretty much all of them, like, by the end, they kind of redeemed themselves a little bit and became more likable and became more funny as the movie went along. Even, like, the most annoying character in the movie, the aunt, like, at a certain point, I was like, you know what, she's not too bad, actually. But anyways, now, let's talk about the horror aspect. Now, is this movie scary? No, but it is suspenseful at times. And the monster design is great. Now, this is some of the best monster design I've seen this year for any movie. And this, the creature design, it's very unique. Like, it's cute, but scary. And, yeah, and I love that there's very minimal CGI in this movie. There's a lot of practical effects, which I did not expect, but it's all very well done. It was done by the Weta Workshop, who, of course, worked on Lord of the Rings. And they're awesome. They're probably better known for their CGI that they did in, you know, also Lord of the Rings and Avatar and Dawn of the Planet of the Apes and Rise of the Planet of the Apes. But they also produce some very good prosthetics and makeup effects, and prosthetics and makeup effects are basically the same, and puppets and stuff like that. Point is, special effects are all spot on. And another thing, just the direction and the cinematography are spot on. This movie looks great. This movie, after seeing this movie, I am just straight up in the Christmas spirit. And I saw it, like, I mean, this video will definitely get posted, especially since I'm obviously recording this after December 4th. But I saw this, like, 2 days after it came out. And, yeah, it just put me in the Christmas spirit. And, I mean, obviously, you know, it has scary stuff, too. But it has just a very Christmassy feel, you know. And, I mean, Gremlins is a scary movie, but still has that very Christmassy feel. You know, it's one of those movies that you gotta watch during the holidays. And this, I will probably buy this movie on Blu-ray, just because of the fact that this is one of those movies that makes you feel like, ah, yes, Christmas, love Christmas. And, yeah, I love the direction of this movie, and this movie has great cinematography. Like, the house is designed very well. You know, when there's, like, blizzard outside, it all looks very atmospheric and creepy, and, you know, there's not shaky cam. It's just, it's really good, and there's definitely some homage. There's a lot of homages to other Christmas movies and other horror movies. I mean, there's, like, without giving it away, like, there's a certain point in the movie to where, like, a character's walking past and there's, like, a knife stabbed into a wall, and it's just, like, stuck there, and there's, like, blood on the wall. I was like, is that a reference to, like, when they saw the axe in the wall in The Thing? Maybe that's just me, but they might have meant that, and I don't know. Maybe that's just me. And, yeah, there's definitely a lot of homages to Gremlins in this movie, as I kind of would have expected, and there definitely are. Not to say that this movie is anywhere near as good as Gremlins. It's certainly not. Maybe I should review that, too. Anyways, but yeah, the movie looks great, it's directed great, the acting's all good, there is good humor. It doesn't all work, but mainly there's good humor. But the thing is, this movie is just kind of simplistic, which I kind of expected, but, like, the thing is, like, you know, a simplistic movie can work, you know, if just the key elements are done very well. And, you know, the key elements in this movie are done decent, but not, you know, like, great. I was hoping this would be a great movie. It's not a great movie, but it is a pretty fun movie. You know, the comedy, it's not great, but, you know, it's fine. The horror is not great, but it's fine. And there definitely are scary scenes in this movie, especially towards the end. It's basically the movie, it keeps on twisting and turning in the end, you know. Like, I was thinking it was going to end, but it didn't end. I thought they were going to do something that I didn't really want them to do, but then it turns around on you again, and I was like, okay, this... Like, overall, I really liked the ending of this movie. It's a good ending. It's, you know, a solid conclusion to the movie, I thought. And it was done well. And technically, this movie, you know, it's delivered in a bleak way, but this movie does have a very good message of, you know, thankfulness. And, you know, giving and stuff like that. But, you know, this is done the way towards, like, don't be thankful. Krampus is going to murder you. You know, but I like that about this movie, too. But, yeah, it's just, you know, very few things in this movie are done great. Like, the special effects look great, and the cinematography and direction are great. But, yeah, just the comedy, it's not always the best, and the horror, it's the movie isn't really scary. It's suspenseful at times, but they're, like, here's the main thing. Oh, and I haven't even talked about Krampus yet, and I'll get to him in a second, but, like, I think they showed a little bit too much a little bit too soon. I think they should have waited until about 40 minutes into the movie until you, like, finally see one of these things, specifically Krampus himself. I don't think they should have actually straight up showed Krampus, like, even in silhouette form, because you see him pretty early on, like, as a shadow, but I thought that even that was too much. Like, maybe, like, a claw or his hand early on, but, like, don't actually show him. Just straight up show him. But, yeah, I think they should have waited until, like, the third act. But, whatever. You know, maybe it's just me. But, anyways, yeah, and let's get to Krampus himself. Now, he is cool, but he's not in the movie enough. Now, I just said that, like, they showed him a little bit too early in the movie, and that's true, but then, like, they show him kind of early in the movie, and again, like, it's in silhouette, you see him as a shadow. But, I mean, there's, like, not that much to the design of Krampus anyway. I mean, it's just, you know, a big old monster and a cloak, and with technically a simplistic design. Very well done. I mean, the puppetry is all great. Like, Krampus looks really cool and scary. But, I mean, like, you know, technically his design is kind of simplistic. So, I mean, seeing him in silhouette, like, basically you're just instantly able to get the idea of, like, okay, yeah, that's what Krampus looks like. They shouldn't have shown him so early. They should have waited until at least halfway through the movie. However, that being said, Krampus is very cool. He's creepy looking. The design is great. The big old horns that go around or on his head, I mean, that looks pretty creepy. And he does creepy things, and yeah, he's a douche. He's not a nice, okay, I was going to say not a nice person. Well, he's not a person. He's not a nice demon. He's not a very nice demon. But overall, he wasn't in the movie enough, and they kind of showed him at the wrong times. Like, they shouldn't have shown him at the beginning. They should have, if you're going to show him just a little bit, then you just wait until the end, and then show him, like, pretty much all in the end. You get what I mean? But maybe I'm just nitpicking. But overall, it's a solid movie, and I will buy it. It gives me the Christmassy feel. And, yeah, it's a fun movie, and it also helped that, like, after the movie, like, I came home, and, like, my Christmas tree, like, my family had already decorated and put the lights on it, so that was pretty cool, like, while I was at the theater. So, anyways, overall, I enjoyed this movie, and I will rewatch it, but it kind of wasn't as good as I was hoping it would be, but that's okay. It doesn't have to be a perfect movie. Anyway, guys, I suppose I should give this movie a B. It's a solid movie. As for gore ratings, there's pretty much no gore in this movie. I give it a 2 out of 7, a little blood. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this review. If you liked it, please rate and comment and subscribe. And if you want to, you can also share. Goodbye.